Here's me performing arthroscopic surgery of the ankle for footballer's ankle. The camera is viewing through the anteromedial portal, viewing laterally, and we've established an anterolateral portal, again avoiding the superficial peroneal nerve. Initially, we use a soft tissue resector to perform a cyanotectomy and clear soft tissue from the anterior compartment so that we can get good visualization of the tibial spurs. As the cyanotectomy is performed, the tibial spur comes into better vision medially. It's noteworthy that the camera is placed anteromedially with the 30 degree scope viewing laterally so one can view along the entire anterior border of the distal tibia. Pressure is normally maintained at 80 millimeters of mercury. The teeth of the shaver are at all times kept away from the articulating surfaces. Here one can see me removing soft tissue from the undersurface of the anterior tibial spur. The talar dome is beneath us, the distal tibia at approximately 10 o'clock on the arthroscopic screen. The yellower element of the tibial spur is the bony element of it. It is cleared inferiorly and superiorly so that later the burr can be used to remove the bony spur and restore the normal tibio-talar angle. The entire normal operating time for this procedure is probably in the order of 20 minutes. Here you can see the soft tissue resector being operated through the anterolateral portal. Again, the soft tissue resector is dissecting soft tissues from the anterior aspect of the tibial spur. Similarly now, the soft tissue resector is used to clear soft tissue from the dorsal aspect of the talar neck to expose any talar spurs that are present. Here you can see we're achieving good exposure of the front of the distal tibia. Virtually all soft tissues now have been cleared from the anterior tibial spur.